Greetings, everybody. I just wanted to come to you just for a brief time here. Had something on my mind. We've been hearing all this on the news media, social media, with Mr. Biden stepping down and this Kamala Harris. Going to be possibly the candidate for the Democrat Party. But what I wanted to share, just briefly here, the majority of our mainstream news today is nothing short of just pure unadulterated propaganda. For you that don't know that, They will and are trying to manipulate and culture how you think and what you believe. With lies, part lies, misconstruing facts and truth. And some just, as one old British commentator said, just plain old bald-faced lies. So we got to be very cautious. Very wise when it comes to what we give ear to in this day, that's for sure. Look at facts. Look around you. Look at your bank account. Look what you spend when you go to the grocery store, to the gas pumps. Just look around. You don't have to have a PhD in economics to be able to figure it out. I want to share one little tidbit. We lived overseas in foreign country for many years. If you want to know about America, really want to know about your country, live outside of the country in some other country, and you'll learn more about it than you ever have or ever will living within the country. That I can tell you. We lived up in the mountains in a third world country. We had no electricity. The only running water we had was when you ran to the springs in the bucket and you ran it back to the house. My wife had cooked on charcoal for years. We were serving as foreign missionaries in that country. What we did have was a little shortwave radio that we took immense pleasure in getting to listen to. In the evenings, at a certain time, this Odyssey would come on for children's programs, and I remember, and I'm Shackled. Another radio, popular Christian radio broadcast. And my family would gather around that in the evenings at a certain time when it would come on, and it took much pleasure in listening to those stories and give us a little bit of contact, I suppose, with the outside world. For me, in the morning, most of the time, I would sit on that shortwave radio and I would listen to British broadcasting straight from Europe. And what, for the most part, comes straight from Europe does undergo the censorship that what comes into the United States, just so you know. Then I would also listen to some French broadcast as well. So in the morning, it was sort of a ritual. After reading my Bible and meditating and sitting there in that quiet time, I would listen to my shortwave radio and listen to what was going on outside in the rest of the world. And I remember one morning, that was back when the Clintons were in office, and it was the Whitewater scandal that was taking place. I remember sitting there that morning. I was drinking my Creole coffee and I was enjoying that, and I was listening to the news, and this British broadcaster comes on there, and I can never mimic those Brits, but he come on there and he said something like this. He said, "Today Hillary Rodham Clinton is to stand before the United States Senate Judicial Committee because they have caught her in bald-faced lies." I have serious doubts that ever come across any American airwaves. I'm just sharing that with you because the news media doesn't, they cover up what they want to cover up. They don't tell the truth. They misconstrue. They manipulate what the whole thing. It's not even news anymore. propaganda, Cuba, China, communist and socialist countries have been using propaganda for decades on end. Why? To control and to manipulate the populace. It's going on right here in America, friend. Going on right here. I just wanted to share that a little bit with you. The Apostle Paul talked about in the end time. He said there'd be wickedness in high places. I know they always have been, but it is just the epitome of misinformation and evil in this day in which we're living in. Isaiah declared, the prophet declared, that they would call good evil and evil good. That's the day we're in. So be wise. Be careful what you give ear to. We're in a great age of deception right now. So ask God in heaven for some discernment, some wisdom. And don't just give ear and believe everything that you hear, especially on mainstream news, social media. Be careful what you believe. One thing we can believe, and that's the Bible, the Word of God. That's what we can believe. You can rest on that one. You can bank on it. God bless you. Until next time. Amen. And until next time.